friends. In this quick video, we shall see how a list of items is created by loading the values in it through a text file. So, let us begin with creating a list of questions that are loaded from a simple text file. Here we go. Let us create a list by the name questions because I am going to load some questions in this list. My questions are in a text file. I go to the variables category and click on make a list. I specify the list name as question and click OK. You see the list on the stage? Now, I simply right-click on the list like this and select import option. Next, I locate my text file that needs to be loaded. I select the file and click on open. Here you are. The questions are loaded in the list named questions. Remember that in the text file, each question was kept in a new line. The reason is that each new line of text is added as a new item in the list. Now, I can access any item in the list like this. I take this block from variables category. Item X of list name. I drag drop from looks category, the block say. Next, I adjust these two blocks like this. Here, I change the number of the item position in the list and see how it is working. The item in the list at the given position is accessed and passed to the say block. The list one by one and display it. First, we need to create some variables for this. Let us create the variable question counter that will count the questions one by one. Then, we create the variable total questions to store total number of questions in the list. Let our code run when we click on the sprite AB. So from events category, we take the block when this sprite clicked. Next, we need to set the variables to some initial values. This is called variable initialization. From variables category, we take set block like this. Select the variable question counter and let it be 0. Then, we take the block length of. It is already showing list questions selected in it. So, it means length of list questions. This gives the number of items in this list. There are 5 in our example. Then, we take another set block and select variable total questions in it. Then we place the block length of in the set block like this. So, the variable total questions is set to the length of the list questions, that is, 5 as you see here. Now, we set up a loop of total number of questions. We go to control category and pick up repeat loop. And from variables category, we place the variable total questions here, like this. So, loop will run 5 times in our example. At this point, we need to have another variable to store the current question from the list. We create a new variable current question for this. Now, we pick up set block and select the variable current question in it. How will we get the current question? Let us see. We pick up the block item number of. Place question counter in it like this. And set this whole equation into set block as you see here. Every time the repeat loop runs, question at the position of current question will be picked up. Both, the variable current question is set to 0. To pick the first question, it must be increased by 1. So, we pick up the block change by. Select the variable question counter in it. And place it in the repeat loop before this set block. Now, we need to display this question. For this we have say block. As you know, say block is in the looks category. In say block, we simply place the variable question from the variables category, like this. Finally, we go to the control category. Drag drop the block weight inside the loop like this. It is set to wait for 2 seconds. Let us click on the sprite to see how this is working. As you see here, the questions are spoken by the sprite one by one every 2 seconds. The variable question counter is increasing by 1. Then it is used as an index by the block item of to pick the next question from the list. This question comes into the variable current question, which is displayed by the say block. This way, one by one, the questions are displayed. Interesting. No? Now, let us see how do we handle if user clicks on true or false. We will add letter sprites T and F for true and false. Now, we need to code the sprites T and F. What should happen if user clicks on sprite T? We need to keep track if user has answered the question as true or false. So, if user clicks on sprite T, we need a variable to store user's answer as T in that variable. Let us create the variable user answer which will be set to value T if user clicks on the sprite T. This is the code for clicking on sprite T. If sprite T is clicked, then set the variable user answer to T. Next, we need a variable to mark yes every time user clicks on sprite T or F to signify that user has answered the current question. Let us create variable user answered. It will be set to yes if user clicks on either Sprite or if the same logic will work for Sprite if with only one difference. Yes. You guessed right. First, let us drag and drop the code of Sprite onto Sprite if like this. Notice, icon of Sprite if shakes a little. That means code is copied. Let us now go to the code of Sprite if and make that just one change. Set the value of user answer to if. Now, when user clicks on Sprite, the variable user answer will be set to value t, and for Sprite if, it will be set to value if. What about the variable user answered? It will be set to yes on click of Sprite as well as Sprite if. Where shall we use variable user answered? In the code of UB. Within the repeat loop, set the variable user answered to no as shown here. Next, instead of waiting for next question for 2 seconds, we put the condition until the variable user answered is set back to yes. How do we do that? Place the wait until block in the end of the repeat loop like this. We take equal to block from operators category. Then arrange the variable user answered on left hand side of equal to sign. And set its value to yes. And set this condition in it like this. Now, every time a question is displayed, the user will click on Sprite or if. This will set the value of the variable user answer to yes, and loop will execute again. Variable user answered will be set to no again, and next question is displayed. This cycle will go on as user keep clicking T or if. If user does not click, then loop will wait because user answered had been set to no, and it just waits on the condition wait until user answered is equal to yes. So, the complete flow of logic is like this. When Sprite AB is clicked, inside the repeat loop, variable user answered is set to no. Next, the variable question counter is increased by 1. The current question is fetched from the list questions into the variable current question. Current question is displayed. And the loop halts because it has to wait until the variable user answered is set back to yes. This will happen when user clicks on Sprite or if. On clicking either T or if, the variable user answered will be set to yes and loop will execute again, fetching the next question and so on. See how do we check how many answers the user has answered correctly. First, we need to have a text file that contains all the correct answers for each of the questions. Here is the text file named answers. Now, we go to Scratch and create a list named correct answers. And import the text file answers into it like this. give 1 mark for each correct answer. Let us create the variable score for this purpose. Variable score is shown here on the stage. We need to initialize variable score to 0 when the program begins. Here we go. Variable score is set to 0. Now, we need to check if user's answer matches with the answer in the list correct answers. User's answers are coming in the variable user answer already. Let us check. From controls category, take if block. Then, from operators category, take equal to block and set the variable user answer on its left side, like this. Then, take item off block. Select list correct answers in it. Adjust the variable question counter in it like this. Question counter will always fetch the corresponding true or false from the list correct answers. Put the whole condition in the if block as shown here. Finally, inside the if block, increase the variable score by 1. So, for every correct answer, the variable score will increase by 1, and for every incorrect answer, the if block will be skipped. Congratulations! You have learnt how to handle lists using a loop and seen one real-life implementation by creating a true-false type of assessment. You can use this learning and develop the logic for multiple choice questions too. Try out.